In module 10, we'll be working with radical functions. So the two radicals that specifically we'll be dealing with are square roots and cube roots. On a square root function, the parent function, meaning if I were to just get the x and only take the square root of x, would be a basic shape here, where since a square root is the inverse of a square, and a square, a quadratic function, looks like a parabola, you could even see the workings of a parabola. It would just be turned sideways. Now, the reason why you don't see a parabola is because the domain is restricted, meaning if when I take the square root of a number, the one thing I can't get out of it is a negative. I can't have a negative output, hence why you don't see any negative y's. It has a restricted domain. So basically, if you were to describe the shape of a square root function, it's a half of a sideways parabola. These are some of the points that belong to the parent function. 0, 0, which that's the endpoint. That's where the function ends. 1, 1, 4, 2, 9, 3, if you were to continue. 16, 4, 25, 5. It's points that you saw on a quadratic function, but just with the x and y flipped, it's the inverse of a quadratic function. This is where you would identify the transformation numbers for a quadratic functions, a, b, h, and k. Now, here's a cube root function. A cube root function does not have a limited domain. There's no way to get an error from a cube root function. So this kind of looks like a flattened out S. And just like a square root is the inverse of a square, a cube root is the inverse of a cube. So you saw earlier that a cubic function looked something like this. Well, then now a cube root is just turned on its side. Instead of points like 2, 8, there's 8, 2. If you were to continue going out, 27, 3, 64, 4. So on and so forth. And this is what a cube root function would look like with transformations in it. This is where you would find A, B, H, and K. And then the way that we perform the transformations is the same as we've done all year. Once you get your parent points, your starting points, you perform your transformations by getting each X from the parent point and dividing by B and adding H, and then doing Y times A plus K.